Well, good morning, everyone. Stephen Whiteside here with a look at the North American stock markets for Friday morning. Well, it's rather early right now, but stock index futures are all trading lower in the pre-market, and so we are looking for some selling at the open on Friday morning. Now, the big headline from Thursday's trading action is the new buy signal in the VIX, and of course, that is negative for stock prices going forward. When the VIX is on a sell signal, that's positive for stocks. When it's on a buy signal, that's negative for stocks. And so here we are, the first day of a buy signal for the VIX. Now, yesterday morning, we were looking at the big reversal in the price of crude oil, and we did see fall through to the upside yesterday. So we see crude oil now putting in higher lows and higher highs, and we are looking to see if it'll take out the October high. That would certainly be a bullish indicator for crude oil going forward. Yesterday morning, we were also looking at all the new bearish reversal signals. They weren't major bearish reversal signals on Wednesday, but they still were bearish reversal signals. And so we were looking to see if we got follow through to the downside on Thursday, and that's what happened. And so there's probably about an 85% chance that we put in a top for this move in the market on Wednesday. Now, never follow the Dow. Pros do not follow the Dow. The public follows the Dow. The reason the public follows the Dow is it's the oldest index out there and it's most often quoted by the media. But if you were driving home in traffic yesterday afternoon and you turned on the radio and they told you what the Dow was doing, that was certainly not an indication of what the overall stock market was doing. Financial services stocks continued to move higher on Thursday, and that kept the Dow up. The reality is that the rest of the market was going in this direction, and the SOX index got whacked yesterday. The NASDAQ 100, which generated a sell signal based on Wednesday's close, saw continued selling on Thursday, and so this is not looking very good for the overall stock market. There's the NASDAQ 100 putting in a lower high. And so we put in a low here, a higher low, that was bullish, but now we're looking to see if those lows hold. If they don't and U.S. bank stocks stop leading the market higher, then I think we're going to be in a lot of trouble going forward. Let's move on and we'll do bonds, currencies, and commodity ETFs and then get back to the stock market. The bonds continued to move lower yesterday, putting in new lows for this move. So the futures contract, the TLT, and the XBB. Looking at currencies, and we've been looking for a new sell signal in the US dollar index over the last couple of days. We have a new early warning signal up there and a new early warning buy signal for the Europe. So we may see those two start to move closer together over the next few days. There's a new buy signal for the British pound. We've been waiting for that for a while, but there we are. And we actually made a higher high yesterday for this move. So the British pound is looking rather bullish, higher highs, higher lows, and hopefully we can get some momentum going there. Now, we did trade higher for the Japanese yen after making a new low. The Swiss franc traded into the channel yesterday, and there's the Canadian dollar making a new high for this move. So we've been on a buy signal for a couple of days now. I have not taken out the November high just yet. Certainly that would be a bullish indication if we could do that on Friday. Moving over, looking at our commodity ETFs, and there's the USO continuing to move higher, gapping higher yesterday. The USO, our price targets were 1094. We closed at 1093. Our next price target was 1133. That's what we closed at yesterday. And the next area of resistance is up there at 1172. We might not challenge that on Friday with crude oil down in the pre-market this morning, but that's our next target to the upside is 1172. And of course, if you're trading the USO, hopefully you locked in some profits yesterday up there at the 1133 level. And with crude oil going higher, we also see gasoline going higher, making a new high for this move, and natural gas continued to move higher on Thursday. Looking at our commodity tracking ETF, of course, it is heavily crude oil weighted, but not all crude oil, and it has taken out the October high, so that's bullish for that ETF. Looking at agriculture, we continue to move lower once again on Thursday. Looking at the base metals, no real change there for the base metal ETF or the price of copper. Gold moved lower yesterday, while platinum moved higher and silver was unchanged on Thursday. Moving over now and looking at the stock market, there's that buy signal in the VIX. Of course, that's negative for the S&P 500. We need to close below 2187 and change on Friday. And of course, 2187.50 is an area of previous resistance, and we're hoping that it was going to act as support. But with the futures down in the pre-market this morning, it does not look like that's going to happen on Friday. Now, there's a new VIX buy signal for the NASDAQ, and of course, the NASDAQ has been on a sell signal since Wednesday's close. We saw some selling in the Canadian market yesterday. The Canadian market, we have a new early warning signal up there for the TSX. We're trying to get through the 15,156 level. Couldn't do that. That's held up for the last week or so. We've had several bearish reversal signals, but no real fall through to the downside. So we're looking to see if that happens on Friday. But it looks like the pros are overstretched at the moment and need to take a break. And so wouldn't be surprised if we saw a new sell signal for the TSX sometime early next week. There's the Russell 2000, just a dollar away from generating a sell signal on Friday. And the Zacks Microcap still trading and closing above the upper channel line. So a lot of strength there in the microcaps right now. U.S. bank stocks continued to move higher yesterday. Canadian bank stocks closed slightly higher on Thursday. We saw energy stocks in both U.S. and Canada move higher, but gave up a lot of their gains going into the close. Gold stocks were lower in the U.S. and in Canada, so no joy there. Saw a huge down day yesterday in the semiconductors, and that is not a good sign going forward, while the transports closed slightly higher on Thursday, so still on a buy signal for transports. Let's finish off this morning looking at those FANG stocks, and we're looking for lower prices here, and we certainly got that on Thursday for Facebook. There's Amazon. Apple is now back on a sell signal as of Thursday's close. Netflix, which never generated a buy signal, still closing in the channel, so still holding on. We saw it drop down into that open gap, and so that gap has never been filled. So that's still a legitimate price target to move all the way down to the bottom of this open gap. Certainly nobody's interested in doing that on Friday morning. There's Google moving down yesterday, so it's heading towards those November lows. And there's Tesla back on a sell signal as of Thursday's close. Okay, folks, that is all for this presentation. The big headline from Thursday's trading action is the new buy signal in the VIX. That, of course, is not supportive for higher stock prices going forward. About an 85% chance that Wednesday was the high for this particular move. We've had a great run over the past few weeks, and certainly some sort of pullback is not unexpected here. And we had our run into month end. That is now over, and the market is willing to give up some of its gains. We need those gains. We need to give up some of those gains before you can have any sort of significant Santa Claus rally. And so don't be surprised if the market heads down for the next couple of weeks. Have a great day, folks. And the next time you'll hear my voice is on Sunday.